It is Tuesday afternoon and I am officially finished work for the week until Saturday, which is absolutely fantastic because that means I've got time to get a shit ton of work done on Nevermorrow. So, last I left off, I was working on that client job. I got a bunch of stuff finished. I emailed it off to him. I got an email about lunchtime today saying that they need one revision on the job. So I'm on my way home. It's got to be done by 5 and it's currently 3:30. So I've got an hour and a half to hammer through it, which shouldn't be too hard. I managed to get the other ones finished pretty quickly last night. So I'm confident that it'll be done in time for them. I'm kind of glad I get to do the revision, but at the same time, I just wish I could go home and work on other stuff. So the idea is I want to go home, finish that revision for them, and then as soon as that's done, I'm going to get started on the business cards and the postcard design, because that needs to be done no later than Friday, because if I don't have it done by Friday, I'm going to be paying out the butt just to get to get things shipped as quickly as possible. So if I can avoid that, that's going to be fantastic. I'm still going to have to pay maybe for a slight express postage just to make sure I definitely get them in time. I don't want to be getting to Friday and freaking out. Although I've been lucky in the past where I order that stuff and it arrives at the last minute at the door and it's always fantastic. So I don't want to bank on that though. I want to be 100% certain I'll have that stuff ready to go. So that's the plan tonight. Tomorrow, Jazz has the day off, so we're probably gonna be doing baby stuff. I think the idea is we're gonna go down to the baby shop, get her car fitted with the baby seat, gonna make sure that the baby pram fits in her boot because she's got one of those ridiculously tiny cars. So that's sort of making things complicated. We're hoping we can find something that'll suit, because otherwise we're gonna have to sell her car and buy a new car. And we definitely don't wanna do that because that's money we don't have at the moment. On top of that, tomorrow I'll probably be doing a lot more job searching, which is very soul-sucking and really makes me feel like crap. But I have to do it because if I don't get a job, then I can't support the child and I can't support Jazz and I can't keep a roof over her head. So, you know, that's a catch-22. If I don't do it, crap shit creek. So, yep, that's tomorrow. And then Thursday I've got a class in the morning. From then on, it's just Thursday afternoon and Friday is completely free, so I can just come work on the book as much as I want. That's the plan anyway. That's the current plan. Then I'm working Saturday, and then I think I've got something on this weekend, but I can't remember what it is. We'll find out. I'm really hoping I can fit in maybe a session to go see Zootopia. School holidays are still on too, so it's going to be crazy busy, so I might wait till school holidays are finished. But I really want to catch that flick because everyone keeps saying it's absolutely amazing. So, yeah. That's where I'm at, and I'm driving home now to do my client job, and I will catch you guys later. Goodbye. It is Thursday, the 7th of April, which officially means it's a weekend, and that's ridiculous because I don't know where this month went already. So there's obviously only a few weeks left. That means I've got a week and a few days till Supernova, which I'm still not even close to being prepared for. Yesterday, as I said, yesterday was Wednesday. I didn't do a video yesterday, purely just because it was just a day out for me and Jazz. We went to the doctors to get a checkup on the baby. Everything was fine, which is fantastic news. Found out we don't need to do any more ultrasounds, pretty much, unless there's any complications with the baby. But I think we're gonna opt in and do the 3D ultrasound, because that looks pretty cool. Other than that, it's just sort of all the regular checkups, unless, you know, stuff goes bad, which, yeah, fingers crossed it doesn't. What did we do after that? Went clothes shopping, finally bought some new shirts. I don't know if any of the blokes watching are like me, but I kind of just buy a few shirts and that'll last me for, you know, 4 to 6 months, and then I'll buy a whole bunch of new ones. So something I've always getting a bit conscious about now is that wearing the same stuff, especially because I do these videos so often. I don't want to look like I don't wash my clothes, which I do. I promise I do. I'm not a stinky gross man. Aside from that, went home and just we chilled on the couch, watched some TV, and then I did the business cards. So the business cards are finished now, finally. So I posted some previews of that on Instagram, and I think I posted another preview this morning, and I've also posted up the finished picture and also the Photoshop files on my Patreon page. So for anyone who pledges just $1 or more, They get access to all that. So, and that one I spent a bit of time on. I really wanted to do more with it. I really wanted to match a more painterly style similar to the actual Garbage Pail Kids cards. But I just didn't have the time, especially because I've got to get these postcards done today. So at the moment I'm off to Matt's. We're catching up just for a quick coffee, then I'm coming home, having lunch, and the rest of my day is just going to be tight pencils and inks on those postcards, because if they're not done by tomorrow, then I am up crap creek without a paddle, because I just don't feel like they're going to get to my door in time from the printers. Like I said in the last videos too, like the turnaround's pretty good, but yeah, I'm not the only one doing a convention, so I can only imagine how much busier the printers are going to be too. So that's something I need to keep in mind. So once the postcards and the business cards are done, that means production can begin properly again back on the comic book. I can start inking again. Hopefully I can at least ink a few more pages, then I can take a few with me to the convention just to show people what they look like. So if people, you know, are interested in the postcards, like, oh, can we see more? I'm like, oh yeah, here's a folder with the original pages. They're not for sale yet, but they will be available at the Kickstarter, and they can just get an idea of what the comic's going to look like itself as well, which I think would be nice. You know, just having a postcard with no other material is not to my benefit at all, so it would be good to have some stuff to take, even if I even maybe just put together like a quick preview book or something, just with the pencil pages. I don't know, I'll do something. And I've also got to go through a bunch of the art that I've already done in the past year and just see what would make appropriate prints, because I still want to do some new A4 prints to go in with the old stuff that I've got. I won't do a whole lot, maybe like 5 copies of each, or maybe like 5 or 6 designs, but it'll be something extra. The prints are only going to be $5, so I don't want to go too crazy, but you know, be a little bit, you know, to make some money for me. And also, there's a whole bunch of artists that are going to this convention. I really hope I can pick up some new books as well that people have released, which would be fantastic, because from what I'm seeing, the quality of this year is going to be awesome in the Artist Alley. So, which I found out they've renamed The Alley, because they've broken it up into sections. We've got the Indie Press Zone, we've got the Fan Artists or some crap, and then there's also like the collectible creatives or something. I don't know, but they've segregated everyone into different sections, and already it doesn't even look like it's going to work, because there's a whole bunch of fan artists in the Indie Press Zone, and I think that kind of really defeats the purpose of it all. And on top of that, it's not called the Artist Alley anymore. I mean, despite the fact that, you know, that, yeah, they've segregated it, everyone there's still an artist despite what they're doing. So why are they discouraging the name Artist when now it's just The Alley? It seems crap to me. So anyway, I'm at Matt's now, so I will get back to you guys in a second. All right, it's just after 1 o'clock. I'm finally home. I've had my lunch. I've got a throbbing headache, which I've had since this morning. I'm not sure if I mentioned that before. But I will persevere. I've got the stuff to pencil from what I mentioned before, the postcards, I've got to pencil them now. And so I thought I'd give you guys a preview of what they're looking like before I start penciling them. So here they are. Okay, okie doke. Right, there we go. Okay, so this is the first postcard. I'm doing this one in a portrait style. I can't think of the word right now. So that's the first one, and then I'm doing this one, there we go, and that one there. So this one's got a lot more penciling to do, just to flesh it out, because I'm not happy with some of the composition down here, and I want to add a little bit here, and this is okay, this will sort of fade out into the background as well. But both of these are, let's move over to this one, yeah, both of these are actually panels from the comic book, so they will, you will find these in the comic book, but these will be drawn a little bit differently because I'm going to do them digitally, because I don't quite have the time to mess around doing them traditionally like I'd like to. So yeah, so the idea of this is actually the scene where the astronaut discovers the city in the book, and this is sort of like a bit of a splash page. Yeah. So I figured since I'm going to be drawing this and not doing much else, I might as well record the video for you guys to watch. And included in my weekly video. I haven't been doing much time-lapse stuff anyway, so this is a nice little change of pace for the videos, which is pretty cool. I'll keep it short. I think I've cut this thing down to about, from what was a 40-minute sketch down to a couple of minutes. So, yeah,
pretty much this is a original panel from one of the books. This is the main character sort of discovering really where they are in this planet. It's sort of the big reveal of sort of how wide open and sort of how crazy the landscapes are in the world. And also given a bit of a sight of, you know, how realistic the world is, how Earth-like the world is too. And this is just before the reveal of the city as well. So this allowed me to, now that I've finally done some really, really tight pencils on this, has allowed me to really develop the world and see how I want it to look. And you know, originally in my mind, I had much more a realistic vision of the world, but given the style that I work in, I knew that wasn't going to work. So I'm pretty happy with how it's all looking, and it fits my style pretty well. I'm very happy with that. As you can see, there's a lot of experimenting here and just changing things around from what the original pencils were like. And I also added in that little robotic character next to the astronaut there. Wasn't originally in the comic, but something I've been thinking about for the past week or so. There's a personal assistant that goes along with the character, but I decided I wanted to be more of a physical entity within the book, just as a secondary character. Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll catch you tomorrow.
What's up, guys? It's Saturday. I am on my way home from work. The end of the week is nigh. I have plans to chill out on the couch with Jazz and a friend, or watch movies and eat popcorn and probably a lot of junk food, which isn't healthy for me, but I don't care because it's Saturday night. So I didn't update yesterday purely because I was just hammering through work, and by the time I was done, I got another headache and I was just exhausted again, and I ended up crashing and having a nap, and I pretty much didn't do much after that, which was pretty crappy. And it seems to be a common thing, and I think it's just a matter of I just need to get back into my a healthy zone, start exercising more, which I'm doing again. I did some exercises this morning, and as far as eating, obviously tonight it's going to be one of those things that I probably shouldn't do it, but hopefully it'll be the last time in a while. So maybe one last hurrah, who knows. I'm a man who loves food, but I've been watching a lot of those documentaries as well lately about food and like sugar content and how bad food actually is for you and this and that, and how it should go all natural. And something I'm really trying to consider, but at the same time it's hard because it's not only my food eating habits that need to change, it's Jazz's as well. And because she's pregnant too, I mean, that's not going to be an easy task. So something is just going to have to be gradual, but something I'm constantly conscious about. I mean, I've been a big boy since for as long as I've ever known. So I've always battled my weight. So it's just one of those constant battles that eventually I'll win, but I'm always fighting. So anyway, there's that. I think that's sort of one of the biggest contributors to my constant tiredness and my constant headaches and things like that. And that's really getting in the way of my productivity. So I need to get on top of it as well. So the weather's getting a little bit nicer too. So maybe I can start walking more. I mean, I've got a dog and he sort of gets neglected in the walking area a bit too. Like, we try, but I need to get my ass into gear. Enough about that. That's not what you're here for. You want to hear about comics and art and creation and creativity and all that good stuff. So I'm here to tell you that, yes, I did a shit ton of work yesterday. I finished my postcards, both of them. One, which I was just a massive slug. Honestly, I reckon I spent about 12 hours on the damn thing, but it came out fucking awesome. I'm really happy. I actually shared it up on the 100s group, so a lot of you have probably already seen it. For those of you who hasn't, this is the picture here. And then I did another one, which is going to be a portrait style one. It'll have the same back as the previous one, but nonetheless, it'll just be an extra piece of art that I can promote the comic with. And here's that one. So there's the two of those. I'm pretty happy with the way they turned out. Originally, I wasn't going to do color, but the default settings with the printers that I'm going through, the front of it is color anyway. It doesn't cost me any extra, so I might as well do it. Otherwise, it was originally meant to be black and white like the comic is. But I think the colour really offsets it and makes it a little bit more appealing. I really had a lot of trouble enjoying it as black and white, and I'm still struggling with working in just black and white. So yeah, it's still a challenge, and that's what this comic was all about too. It's that challenge. But given that I was working digitally too, it allowed me to really get into the nitty gritty and be far more detailed than I ever could if I was working traditionally. So that's probably one of the bigger mistakes that I made when I did those pictures, that I got too overconfident with it, and so I just went too far, too much detail, and that sort of was a downfall, but I managed to fix it up. So I'm happy with it. I'm very happy with the end result. So that's awesome. So I'm going to email all that off to the printers today when I get home, hopefully, or at least tomorrow morning. They're generally not open on weekends anyway, so they'll get it on Monday, and hopefully I'll have them no later than Friday. I'm going to have to pay a little bit extra just to get the express shipping happening, but that'll be fine. That's fine. I can handle that. I'll be stressing a little bit. I've also got those covers coming as well, so I've got a few things to rely on in the post next week, and hopefully that all arrives in time for things to go smoothly at the show. I'll probably get all my stuff printed as well at the local printers on Wednesday, just so all that's ready to go. I don't have to stress about that either. So a few little things to do. Supernova's definitely rattled me as far as being, progressive on the comic book front, but it's also allowed me to do a lot of promotional stuff. It's also forced me to finally write my pitch, which is done because I needed that for the postcards. So I'm pretty happy with that as well. What else? On top of that, this morning I woke up early and I finished off another commission, which I've been waiting. I definitely put it on the back burner for these postcards to get finished, just because I wanted to know that they were done. But that's all emailed off to the client now. I haven't heard back from them. Hopefully they like the end results. And that can be finished, and I can email them the final file and they can pay me. And that money can go towards more Supernova stuff, which would be fantastic. Otherwise, I've just got one more commission, that traditional one, which is just itching at me, and I really got to finish it off. And I might try and finish it off tomorrow, but I know we're going to be doing a whole bunch of baby stuff because Jazz has the day off. But she's also doing some late nights, unfortunately, on Monday and Tuesday. So that means I can probably get caught up then as well, rather than end up sitting on the couch watching TV and stuff. So that's where I'm at. I'm looking forward to getting home now and just relaxing, although I've got a few chores to do, just to tidy up the house and stuff before our friend comes around. All that mundane crap that has to be done, but, it keeps me on my toes. Today at work was actually pretty easy. It was a really busy day, but it made it go super fast. So to say that I'm on my way home now, I feel like I should probably still be at work. But according to my clock, I'm fine. So whatever. Alright, I hope you guys are having a great week. I'll update once more tomorrow before I upload this video. I'm definitely enjoying these videos a lot more, just doing the big chunks. They are a lot more fun, but at the same time I miss uploading daily as well. So I'm trying to build up a bunch of time-lapse videos and stuff of the things I've been working on, so then I can post those up with maybe just like an audio commentary for you, or even maybe just some backing music, but I like to talk, Clearly, I've been going for nearly 8 minutes now. It's ridiculous. So, I'll probably do those. I'll just get a bit of a backlog of those, I reckon, and just post them up in segments. Just to vary up my YouTube, videos as well. Anyway, I'm home now, so I'll catch you guys tomorrow. Have a good one. Peace. Hey, guys. It is Monday, April. I can't remember. All I know is this month is going way too friggin' fast, and it just feels like March, and I feel like by the time I blink, some idiot just made all these seagulls fly right in front of my car. That jerk. Anyway, it was the same. Yeah, this month's going way too quickly already, and it's Supernova next weekend. I can't believe it, which means half the month is over. But, good news, I can't even remember what I updated the other day, because I skipped yesterday's update, which was Sunday, because Jazz has been homesick. She went to the doctors today, and she's discovered that she has a sinus and chest infection that she needs to get sorted out. So she's bedridden, well, not bedridden, couch-ridden, maybe, pretty much, for the next few days. So right up until Wednesday, she's going to be at home with me, resting while I work, which is good. It's always nice when she's around. Hopefully she gets better pretty soon. I'm just hoping that I don't get sick as well. So I'm taking every goddamn vitamin and whatnot that I can find around the house to make sure that I don't catch her infection, because I really don't need that coming up to supernova. That's going to suck if I do get sick. Probably to the point where I'm going to have to pull out, and that's not cool. Especially after all this organising I've been doing. But yeah, so I've got all the postcards finished and the business card finished. There were a couple of changes I need to make, just to the text and some of the links and stuff. Like my business card, I had my website, which I've decided to change to my Patreon link. So I figured it'd be easier if they can just go directly there rather than have to find out randomly through like my website or something, which I'll probably miss anyway. So if I can direct them directly, people might go, oh cool, I use Patreon, so I'll follow you or something. So that's the plan. And then also just had to fix up the little blurb on the back of the postcard for Nevermorrow as well, just a few little typos and stuff, so I had to had some friends edit it for me. So that's done, sent that off to the printer yesterday morning, paid express shipping, which was about $20, but thanks to Vistaprint, they had a deal which was $20 off if you spend more than $40, which I definitely did. So the $20 that I saved went to the shipping anyway. So what was a $60 order could have been an $80 order. So I'm pretty happy with that. So they should come on Wednesday at the latest, it said. They've also got those plastic bags coming. I've got to get prints done, which I'll probably do on Wednesday. And that's done. Ideally, what I want to do is I want to make sure everything's done and dusted by Thursday. So when Friday comes along, it's either just last minute preparation, just getting little bits and pieces, or pretty much nothing. I don't want to have to do anything on Friday. I want to actually be able to relax and have a day off, because I'm then going to be working Supernova for the weekend, and then I've got to go straight to work Monday, Tuesday. So it's going to be full on, and I'm just going to be exhausted. So Friday's going to have to be my weekend, and possibly Thursday night, or at least Thursday night will just be the last minute packing. Anyway, and it looks like I might not have to drive. I might be going with Dean, which is really awesome of him, but I'll be talking to him during the week to organize that as well, because if I can organize, you know, not having to drive, you know, it's nice. I don't really like driving to the city, but you know, I will if I have to. I'll just sling him some money for petrol and maybe buy him a coffee or something. So there's that. Yesterday again slept in. Yesterday I finally got back into the inks of the book, so I finished page 4. So the first 4 pages are finished and inked, and now I've just got to print out the next lot of pages and get them prepared so I can start inking those as well. The inking went a lot quicker than I thought it would, which was fantastic. And I think I owe it all to the fact that I spend a bit more time on the pencils. Sometimes I just go from thumbs to inks, and it takes me forever trying to figure things out. So by actually doing tight pencils at the beginning, that worked out well for me. So yeah, saving a bit of time there. Going home, go back to the shops with Jazz and get some dinner and get her some antibiotics and stuff. And then when I get home, I'll just be working back on the comic book and getting some more pages done. The more pages I can get done before the show, the more I can take and show off to people as well. So, you know, when they get the postcard, they're like, oh, what's this about? I can show them the pages and get them even more excited. And that's the plan. Ideally, shit, if I could get some more pages done, I'd actually do like a little preview book, but I'm not going to stress myself out with that at this point. So, yeah, I think I'll leave it at that. I think I'll just leave it at the postcards, the business card, and some of the prints I'm going to take. I'm also going to do commissions as well. I'm thinking I've got the option of getting a bulk load of A5 watercolor paper for really cheap at the moment from work, and that's a lot of watercolor paper. Like, yeah, 100 sheets for like, I think it works out at like 44 cents each or even less, and it's really good stuff. Like, it's Archer's watercolor paper, you know, the good French stuff. So if I can get that, maybe I could do the commissions at, I'm thinking like $20 inked and maybe like $40 to $50 coloured, and I'll just colour them in watercolour. That saves me from having to take all of my markers, which is ridiculous because there's about 3 kilos of markers, or maybe like 1 kilo, but there's a lot of markers. It's heavy as to carry around. This way I can just take my watercolors, my refillable water brushes, and save a whole lot on, you know, all the stuff I have to carry around, because it gets so heavy to lug around. I can't be bothered with it this year. I just want to pack light, go have fun, make a bit of cash just to cover the printing costs and stuff, and maybe a little bit of money to pay off some credit card bills. That'd be nice. That's really all I want to do. Mostly I just want to have fun. You know, I don't want this to be a stressful weekend. I want it to be fun and hang out with my mates that I don't get to see all the time. So yeah, so I'm still deciding on that, but I'm definitely going to do commissions. It'll either be on the watercolor paper, or I'll just get some regular paper, and might just do black and whites, because I really don't want to do marker stuff this weekend. I just cannot be bothered with markers. It's just too much hassle, too many color choices and all that crap. So it's either watercolor or black and white, and that's it. Yeah, so this is the last episode for, or the last update for this episode. Firstly, I want to say thank you to everyone who's liked and commented all the previous videos. You guys are absolutely awesome. I wouldn't be doing these without yous. Even though I'm doing the comic, I do these videos for you guys, because I think they're just a lot of fun to do, and it's awesome to interact with you guys once the videos are done. It's awesome to just chill out and stuff. Sorry, the lady outside is on her phone and it distracted me a little bit. She's talking very, very loud. Although there's a lot of cars around, so that probably explains why. so yeah, thank you. Thank you for the likes, the comments, the shares. If you haven't, please subscribe to the channel, because then you'll get updated regularly. I'm still working on getting those videos done, like the time-lapse video, so I'm just building a buffer of all that for you. And for those who aren't on my Patreon too, I'm finally back doing the daily sketches now that things are a bit more up to date. And I'm doing... not only do you get the Photoshop files now, but I'm also uploading the time-lapse files too. So it's usually like about a half hour to an hour drawing session, knocked down to about 2 minutes with a little bit of music and stuff. Nothing too fancy, but you know, you get to watch that. You can download the PSD file and break it all apart and stuff. And you get that just for $1 a month. And I usually do my daily sketches now. Sometimes I try and do them every day of the week. But you'll at least get like 2 or 3 a week. You'll get the preview pages to Nevermorrow and stuff. So it's worth following along. And $1 is really not a lot per month too. I mean, by the time you add that up by the end of the year, that's like two coffees at Gloria Jeans or Starbucks or wherever it is you buy your coffee. So, you know, and you'll be helping me out a lot too. And, you know, I really appreciate it. And, you know, those people do get to see a lot more than what I post normally. So there's that. Shout out to all the guys who are doing the 100 days at the moment. Plex, he's awesome. We're talking about me possibly jumping on his podcast soon, which would be fantastic fun. And then there's Mike Emirates. He's sorry, I should say Plex is Marsh Makes Art. Check him out pretty much everywhere under that name. Then there's Mike Emirates, who's doing the Space Cat 100 days. He's just a funny dude, man. I really, really enjoy Mike's videos. I don't know what it is about him. I think it's just because every video he does, he's just so overtired, and I think I enjoy it way more because of that. I don't know. But Mike's cool. I can't wait to see Space Cat too. I actually really dig his art style. Who else? Peter Palmiotti. I've been watching his, although I don't think I've seen him upload any videos lately, so I hope you're okay, Peter, man. I want to see more updates from you. And who else? There's other people I'm missing. If I missed you, I'm really sorry. I'll try and remember to pop some links down in the bottom as well. I think I missed it last week. Alright, that's me. I've been talking for far too long. This video is probably going to go up tonight, so you'll be pretty up to date by the time it goes live. And, the last thing I was going to say is the next video I'm doing, so as of tomorrow onwards, is just going to be pure Supernova. I'm just going to focus entirely on Supernova for the videos. I'll probably update general stuff as well, but for the most part, I'm going to try and focus it on Supernova, on the things that I'm doing. Like, I'll post it when I get like all my, I'll do a video when I get all my packages and things like that. And it'll pretty much just be my entire Supernova experience in one video. So it'll sort of be like a video update special, I don't know, something like that. That's the idea. I really wanted to do, focus it just on the convention so people can actually see what it's like from behind the scenes. So I don't think anyone's done it in Australia, or for the Australian cons anyway, that I've seen. I could be wrong. If you have seen some from Australian cons, please link me. I'd love to watch them. Anyway, that's it for me. I hope you guys have had a stellar week. I will catch you all after the supernova update. Have a good one and goodbye.